My father Peng Boshan was practically a stranger to me. In 1955, before I turned 2 years old, he was arrested. In official record, his crime was being the spokesman of Hu Feng clique within the Communist Party. Many were shocked that my father, the minister of propaganda in Shanghai, was condemned just because he was a friend of Hu Feng. Hu Feng was born in 1902. He founded the July magazine in 1937. The magazine gave rise to the July School of Poets and Writers, who looked up to Hu Feng as a successor of Lu Xun. His name, however, was almost unknown outside the literary circles.
毛泽东对鲁迅的赞美最早的一篇公开文字就是1931年4月19号鲁迅逝世一周年毛泽东在那个展碑公学的一个纪念大会上的讲话他中间就说鲁迅是什么当代的第一个圣人国民党要争夺知识分子太容易了是吧要做官我可以做要钱我可以给钱共产党也没法给他人家做官也没有多少钱给人家
1942, Mao gave his famous Yan'an talks in the Forum of Arts and Literature to cultural workers in Yan'an.
Mao, in the Yan'an talks, explicitly states that literature should be a screw, a kind of cog in the wheel of the larger political revolution. So in the Yan'an talks, literature takes a very, very clearly stated secondary status to politics.
Soon, many would see that Mao's Yan'an talks were only part of a larger rectification campaign aimed at eliminating dissenting voices within the party. When the campaign extended from the communist base in Yan'an to the nationalist capital in Chongqing in 1944, Hu Feng's ideas on the role of writers as subjective individuals became a basis for attack.
很记得48年解放战争的前一年，香港开展了一次批判。这里头就已经把胡风置于延安文艺座谈会的对立面，这是48年的事。尽管他写了很多文章，他发现了很多人，很多人写的文章都是国损共产党的，特别是诗人们，这不能解决问题。 书屋在这长江日报里就写了一篇重新学习延安文艺座谈会讲话，他这里头首先就把自己跟胡风抛出来了，就是我过去说的胡风的这个错误思想的影响，写了一些很坏的文章。现在呢，胡风还有几个人，最有名的是还有几个人，那就包括罗林，我们这些人都在内，这个这就是个小集团的问题，《北京人民日报》。
The so-called Hu Feng clique members were arrested in most major cities in China. Nearly all of these prisoners went through a painful period of interrogation and solitary confinement. Lu Ling, a talented novelist, refused to read or write. He often cried out loud like a trapped beast. Everyone remembered hearing him. He finally went insane and was released temporarily for medical care. At home, he wrote over 30 appeal letters. On one of the envelopes, he named the receiver as Queen Elizabeth. When he took the letters to the post office, he was arrested by a district police officer and sent back to Qincheng prison, where he would suffer various physical tortures for making troubles. One peculiar aspect of the Hufeng incident was that the public trial did not come until 1965, 10 years after the private arrests and the national campaign.
把它关起来嘛，这个把它关起来，这个东西拿来讲一个国家，说应该做点的人民都有自由嘛，是不是？经过了法院判决，再关你，那就名正言顺了。检察长就说胡峰判14年，阿龙判12年，贾子方12年，这个这么大一个案子，三个人服刑，其余的人免于起诉。这是当宽大吧？
In December 1984, when asked about his writing plan, Hu Feng said,6 months later, in June 1985, Hu Feng passed away. As the redress on his case was still not completed, his official funeral was put off till January 1986. Nearly all his friends who were alive attended his funeral.
Do not step on the dew, as someone cried last night. My dear, I remember well, I read Psalm of Songs for you in candlelight. Do not pray for me, please. I am not guilty, and I will die naked as I was born. Do not measure the space between stars, in light years, gravity, or flashes. Bloom as a white flower, I will claim our innocence before we wither.